Hi everybody, welcome to Greenhouse. We're going to talk about Pentecost a little bit today and then more next week. May 23 is Pentecost, so we're going to spend some time on May 16 and May 23 talking about it. Today I'm going to read you a really cool book called God's Very Good Idea. Let's light the candle to get started. Here we go. We always do a call to worship, just like we do in the regular service upstairs or outside. Our call to worship is from Psalm 47. Come in, come in, come one, come all. Lift your heart, clap your hands, shout praise and sing joy to our God, the highest one, the majesty of majesties. Come see the world from God's point of view. In him, the victory has already been won. All that troubles us is overcome under our feet. In him, we are at home. Come, claim your inheritance. Come home to his love. Our praise song today is from Maker Fun Factory, and it's called He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. And that kind of goes with our book, talking about God's delightfully big family and all the different people that are in it. He's got the whole world in his hands. If you'd like to stand up and move and sing, please do that with me now. Globe. I love seeing this every week in Greenhouse. It reminds me to pray for our missionaries. It reminds me to pray for all parts of the world. Okay. The next thing we do is our confession so we can worship with a clean and pure heart with joy. So let's pray. Now that we've been called, Lord, and gathered to worship and we've praised you, we're going to confess our sins before you, God, and we pray. We know that you love us. We want to grow. We want to learn. Help us confess our sins so we can worship you with joy. Forgive us, Father, when we've sinned by loving other things beside you. Forgive us. Father, we've disobeyed you and our parents and teachers. Forgive us. Lord, help us to have a good, strong relationship with you and forgive us when we think of ourselves before you. Forgive us. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to take away all our sins. Open our hearts and ears to hear your word and learn more about you. In your name we pray, amen. Our scripture today is from Acts 2, verses 1 through 4. We're in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts. So here we are, right after John. The title of this section is The Holy Spirit Comes at Pentecost. So what does that mean? Let's read. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak to each other in tongues as the Spirit enabled them. We're going to talk about Pentecost and read a book today that has Pentecost in it. And then next week, we're going to do a lesson about Pentecost and also talk about God's big Pentecost story, which I'll have available for everyone starting this past week. You may have even seen it. So here's our book. It's by Trillia Newbel. It's illustrated by Catalina Echeverria. It's called God's Very Good Idea, a true story about God's delightfully different family. See all these light bulbs? God's very big idea. Good idea. In the beginning, in fact, before the beginning, God had a very good idea. It was even better, a better idea than solar panels. The super soaker. Color TV. Chocolate chip cookies. It was even a better idea than fireworks or roller skates, the life raft, or the x-ray machine. God's idea was to make people, lots of people, lots of different people who would all enjoy loving him and all enjoy loving each other. They would be all made in his image. They would all be like mirrors reflecting what God is like. Because God is full of love, they would be full of love too. So God got to work and he made a beautiful world for people to live in. And then he made the first people, a man and a woman. And he said to them, be happy, enjoy loving me and loving each other. Have a huge family that will fill the earth and look after the earth and enjoy the earth. God carried on creating people. All of them were made in his image, and all of them were different too. Some were men, some were women, some liked reading, some had darker skin, some had lighter skin, some liked riding bikes, and some had curly hair, and some had straight hair. We live in God's world, and we are all different, but we are also all the same. Everyone you see is different than you, and the same as you. They might look different, or speak different, or play different, but they are all made in God's image, and so they are all valuable. There's so many things to see on these pages. I'm trying to show you all the pictures. But people ruined God's very good idea. The first people chose not to love God. This is called sin. And because they chose not to love God as they should, they forgot how to love each other as they should.
We are the same. We chose not to love God, and so we are not able to love each other like we should because we sin. And sometimes we treat others badly because they're different than us. People fight with each other, and people are mean to each other, and people laugh at each other. Because we have ruined God's very good idea, He is not pleased with us. Our sins mean we can't be friends with Him or enjoy living with Him. We need God's forgiveness for ruining His very good idea. It's the same for everyone in the world. People who like reading need forgiveness, and people who like riding bikes need forgiveness, and people with darker skin need forgiveness, and people with lighter skin need forgiveness. People with curly hair need forgiveness, and people with straight hair need forgiveness. But God was not surprised by people ruining things. He always has a very good rescue to His very good idea. So God got to work, and He came to earth as a person, Jesus. Jesus loved people who were different than Him. He loved people who no one else would love. He says to this woman, "Your faith has made you well." This man says, "I can see." Jesus is healing him. He always enjoyed loving all the different people he met. Jesus shows us how to enjoy loving each other. But people didn't love Jesus. Instead, they hated Him. They put Him on a cross to die. But this was part of God's plan. On the cross, Jesus took our sins so that we can be forgiven. Jesus forgives His people for their sins. Jesus didn't stay dead. He rose back to life, and then He went back to live in heaven. And then He gave people His Spirit to help them enjoy loving Him and loving all the different people they know. Jesus helps us to love one another. One day, God will finish His very good idea, and Jesus will come back and make the world perfect again. And anyone who has asked Jesus to forgive them will live there with their different languages and skin colors. They will enjoy loving God and loving each other, and they will enjoy praising God for making, rescuing, and finishing His very good idea. But here's a very, very, very good part of God's very good idea. You don't have to wait until then to enjoy it. Jesus welcomes anyone who asks Him to forgive them. And when Jesus welcomes someone, He welcomes them into His family forever. He welcomes people who like reading and people who likes riding bikes. He welcomes people with darker skin, and He welcomes people with lighter skin. He welcomes people with curly hair and people with straight hair. Look at all those different people in this picture. God's family is called the church. Your church friends are your brothers and sisters. Your wonderful and colorful church family, and you can enjoy loving them and loving God with them. This is God's very good idea. Lots of different people enjoying loving Him and loving each other. God made it. People ruined it. He rescued it, and He will finish it. And with your church family, you can enjoy being a part of it right now. Isn't that amazing?
Everyone you see is different than you and the same as you. We look different, we speak different, we play different, but we're all valuable. And that's because in the beginning, God had this very good idea of making us that way. I hope you enjoyed this story of his idea and how you can be a part of it. Next week, we'll talk about the page more where it said that God shared his spirit. It says, then he gave his people his spirit to help them enjoy loving him and loving all the different people they know. We'll talk about that more next week. And that's the event that is called Pentecost that we read about in the scripture. Let's sing our doxology to finish. Candle to finish our worship time together. Thank you for joining me. Bye-bye.